s'installe ?
Ouais. Ah, je trouve vraiment que c'est une ville surprenante, audacieuse. J'ai l'impression qu'on respire ici.
C'est possible, je sais pas.
Ouais, tu peux m'amener l'addition, s'il te plaît ?
Merci.
Ah non, c'est pour moi, c'est pour moi.
C'est chez moi, je t'aide.
Merci.
Merci.
Tu fais quoi?
J'ai ça pour boire.
On y va?
Everybody probably knows the whole Bitcoin coming up. There are 600 different forms of a blockchain currency at the moment, and some of them are very, very successful in getting the attention. The problem is, if we are going to create a currency for the wine industry, which is going to support exactly what we do, how can we make sure that we make the right choices? Because there are a lot of design choices to make. And we don't have to make a mistake where we just have the wrong handshake. So to make this easier, we created the Community Currency Implementation Framework. But this is for European funding. It's a framework that everybody can download, he can work with, where we go pretty logical cycle. We start with the aims, go for the objectives, try to identify end users, end user groups, see which partners we need to do it with. Then we create a currency model, and we end up with all the normal project details. So the goal, as we describe it, could be: we want to have a currency for wine lovers so they find the market easier. Or we want to have a currency which is helping producers to find the ones that are wanting to buy their wines. Or we can even have a tool which is supporting conferences like this. So I'm going through a potential simple model as it could look like. So all these yellow dots, this is basically you as you're sitting here. Everybody we can attract to what we do. We form a community collectively, and we are going to use a currency. So I named my currency very originally bottles, corks, and barrels. So it could be 10 corks in one bottle and 10 bottles in one barrel, or whatever we like to do. And we get them by buying them on the internet. So the blue line is euros. We bring euros to the exchange, and we get an amount of bottles back in return. And we can start then to use these bottles to pay, for example, a winery for a box of wine, or we go to a wine tasting, or we are able to get a course in wine drinking, etc., etc. All the type of things that you are speaking about. And we could include other industries that are close by. For example, we could include restaurants, we could include hotels, transport, airplanes, whatever, everything basically which you need to be close to your hobby. The problem is, of course, that if a winery or a restaurant gets our bottles, they want to have something like cashback. And we allow them to do that because they can transfer the bottles that they have back to the exchange, and exchange would then give the euro, so they have the money to pay the personnel. And they will pay a fee if this happens, and this fee allows us to do the whole system. So in this whole cloud of people using the currency, we can have the opportunity to have communities. So we would probably work together with other applications, maybe even with YouTube, and combine this as much as possible, and just see how this would work out. Another feature that we can add, and there are tens of features like this, is that each time when you transfer a bottle to somebody else, you get a card, an item, and certain combinations of these cards would give you a special prize. For example, if you have four queens, then you're allowed to go to one of these beautiful wineries in the south of Germany, spend the night there, get a beautiful trip around in the fields, and do a lot of experiences. Other option is that the Star Restaurant in Dijon decides to join, and they are going to accept these bottles, and they give away prizes also, and this could be beautiful food. Third example is that next year you probably can buy your ticket for this conference using bottles. And the last example is that you get a beautiful night together with Ryan. I didn't have the right photograph here. Or with Gabrielle, if you have a different choice, with a good glass of wine, of course. So we need to have other things organized, otherwise it doesn't work. And we need a good marketplace. We can use things that are already there, or we can create something just for this one, or we work on basis of an API so others are able to create these marketplaces. And we also need a payment system. Now, payment systems, there are a lot of them there. It's quite cheap to build them these days. So we could have both mobile payments for things that can take a little time, or we could have an NFC option or something alike to do the very fast things. So even here, if you would go to, for example, the coffee machine, you could just stick your NFC card and the payment is done. It could be this simple, no problem at all. So, and by doing that, we would be able to grow the industry. We would be able to do more with the same type of money. We would make sure that the euros that we normally spend on the thing that we love so much is continually circulating in the community as we have it by enabling more and more and more features. So we are from COIN, we support this type of systems, and I really hope that the organization will have the courage to test this one next year. Thank you.